or something irrelevant. Hi, you guys, it's Yaz, and today I want to talk about covert narcissistic mind games. And this is why the covert narcissist is so difficult to spot, because they play mind games, all right? They're not clear, they're not transparent, and they will leave you in the dark. So here's what I have to say about all of this, you guys. When you're dealing with a covert narcissist, understand this. They're not direct with anything. They're indirect, and they will pay you back in an indirect, passive-aggressive manner. Covert narcissists are all about passive aggression. So how are you going to be able to recognize you're dealing with this covert narcissist? Well, they play a lot of mind games, and the way they do it is like this. In other words, a covert narcissist is going to tell you everything is all right. They pretend everything's all right when they're secretly pissed off, and they will try to pay you back in an indirect way, passive-aggressive way. So what would that look like? Well, they may show up late when they're supposed to be, let's say, at a restaurant for an important meeting, or there's a family get-together and they show up late. They may have a face on at a family get-together, or if you're out with your friends, they sit there with a sullen look on their face and they're just there in body. These are all ways that, covert narcissists, they play mind games, and they'll say, "Well, I was there. What's your problem? You're being sensitive." They're there, but when you look at their nonverbal language, it tells you how they're feeling. And this is what you have to do when you're dealing with a covert narcissist. You've got to look at the nonverbal clues that the covert narcissist is giving off, okay? A smirk. Covert narcissists love to smirk. It's their way of saying, "You know what? You're an idiot," and everything like that, without actually coming out and saying it, so that you can never call them out on it. Covert narcissists are cowards. They don't have the guts to take you on toe to toe. The only time a covert narcissist will come out and take you on toe to toe is if you've got them cornered. You've really got them cornered, and there's nowhere for them to go, or they're extremely, extremely pissed off. They may snap and then really come at you like that. But most of the time, a covert narcissist is going to pay you back with outsiders. Covert narcissists love to use triangulation. They love to get everybody against you. They're flying monkeys, the outsiders, the family, the friends. They'll talk badly about you. Covert narcissists love to gossip. They love to, put you down, or they love to plant a seed. See, this is what a covert narcissist does. They plant seeds in other people's minds about you. Like, they may say something, that you did, and try to make it sound like, you're mentally unstable, or, they need help, or, they take everything to heart, or they're insecure, or they have trust issues, or something like that. They're going to plant the seed in outsiders' minds to make you look bad, so that when you come around these outsiders, they're going to look at you differently. And what the covert narcissist is going to do is they're going to give these outsiders, they're going to win these outsiders over with honey, okay? That's how they win them over. They kill these outsiders with honey. Why? Because they want them to side with the covert narcissist when you have a falling out with that covert narcissist. Who are these outside people going to side with? They're going to side with the covert narcissist, because the covert narcissist has made them feel good. The covert narcissist has flattered them. The covert narcissist has maybe done favors for them, because they know that later on they're going to be able to use these people on their team against you. This is how they operate. So they play a lot of, mind games, and covert narcissists feel validated, when they do triangulation, because they'll say something like, "Well, even Aunt Jane thinks, there's something wrong with you, or, you need to get some mental help," or, "Even Aunt Jane says, you can't get your act together, you're a loser," or something like that. And this is how the covert narcissist tries to invalidate you, because they feel that the more people that they can call out and name that agrees with them, the more it validates their argument. But the fact is, if it's not the truth, it doesn't matter if they have a whole army behind them. But these are the games that the covert narcissists play. Another game that covert narcissists love to play is they'll have a lot of acquaintances, okay? Covert narcissists, you know, they validate themselves by how many contacts they have, how many people they know. They're always like networking. Not that these people are their close friends, but they network. So it makes them feel like they're somebody. Oh, I know somebody that works in that department, or, you know, I was with this celebrity, or I took a picture with that athlete or something like that. That makes them feel important because a covert narcissist is extremely, extremely insecure. So they're going to use these people and try to make themselves feel like they're something. A covert narcissist is worried about their image. So they're going to cut you down in order to make themselves feel better, okay? And this is why they're so evil and so deadly. Like somebody put a comment on, you know, one of the posts and they said, covert narcissists, passive aggressive covert narcissists will kill you slowly. And why is that? Because over time, first of all, most of the time when you're dealing with a covert narcissist, you don't even realize they are a covert narcissist. You just realize that they're difficult or something's off or they're cold or, you know, they run hot and cold with you. They give you their back or they don't validate what you say or they, you know, they dismiss you. They act like they don't hear you. They try to make you feel like you're unimportant. The other thing is covert narcissists, when they're out in a group, a lot of times they'll ignore you and be very friendly to outsiders. And people say all the time, why is the covert narcissist so friendly to outsiders but cruel to me? Because the covert narcissist wants to win these other people over to have them in their court, okay? It gives them more power to know that they have these outside people. And plus, they figure if things don't work out with you, they have their little connections. They're prospecting for other supply, you know, to reach out to today or tomorrow, or if they have a fight with you, these other people will back them because they've manipulated them. They've worked on them. They've buttered them up, okay? So these are the mind games that they play. Covert narcissists also will have a lot of these acquaintances, and they could have situationships with these acquaintances. But what they're going to tell you is, oh, that's just a friend, or you're insecure, or you have trust issues, or something like that. Like if you ever go to a covert narcissist and you tell them that you got cheated on in the past or anything like that, and now that covert narcissist is, you know, out creeping and you question them on something that doesn't look right, what's the first thing they're going to say? They're going to say, oh, you have trust issues because you got hurt in your past. No, not because you got hurt in the past, because that covert narcissist is sending off bad signals, red flags, and you need to trust your gut. Covert narcissist will be there in body, but not in mind. The covert narcissist is always thinking, their minds are always somewhere else. And you'll know that when you're with a covert narcissist. A lot of times you're sitting with them on the couch and you're talking to them and you feel like they're not even listening to you, or they just nod their head, or they give you that little smirky smile. But they have this attitude like they don't care. They don't care. Why? Because their mind is somewhere else. They're thinking about something else. Because covert narcissists are sneaky. They have, you know, a secret life somewhere else. And what does that mean? That means that covert narcissists are usually talking to somebody that you don't know about. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a love interest. It could be a mother that they talk to on the side about you. It could be another friend of theirs or something like that. They know something that you don't, and that gives them a sense of power. They're never completely open. They never let their wall down. And this is why you will never feel completely connected to that covert narcissist. And why is that, gang? Because a covert narcissist doesn't trust anybody, okay? These are wounded individuals, usually from their childhood, and they're on guard. Even with their own family, they don't even trust completely their own family, okay? So the thing is, they will send out subtle, indirect messages, and it's up to you to pick up on these messages. What are these messages? In other words, when you confront a covert narcissist on something, that covert narcissist is usually going to stonewall you and walk out of the room, or if you text them, they're not going to respond to your texts. A lot of times, covert narcissists will leave you on read and not respond to you. And what is that going to do? That's going to create an uneasiness within yourself. And what does that do? That makes you doubt yourself. And you're going to sit there and say, maybe I shouldn't have sent that text. Maybe I shouldn't have brought that up to them. And the way the covert narcissist controls you and what you have to say is by silence. Silence is the tool of the covert narcissist. They will be silent towards you. They will ignore you around other people. They will ghost you, okay? And they'll come back and they'll make like nothing ever happened, okay? This is exactly what covert narcissists do. And I've seen it time and time again. That's why I know it's so good, you guys, all right? A covert narcissist, you know, after they've given you that silent treatment, they're going to come back and they're going to make like you never had an argument. They're going to come back and say, you know, they're going to bring up something stupid like, you know, how are the kids or how you feeling or, you know, oh, you know, did you ever go to that show or something irrelevant to the argument that you had. They're not going to bring it up. Why? Because they don't want to talk about it. They don't want to take accountability because then they have to face shame. So covert narcissists will sweep it under the rug. That's why they'll always say something to the effect of when they come back, well, you know, let's just move on, okay? Let's not look back. And the problem with that is if you don't resolve the initial conflict, it's going to come up again, okay? It's going to come up again. So in order to solve your problems, you've got to face your problems. And this is something that a covert narcissist won't do. Now, somebody commented and they said something to me to the effect of, could you please mention about drugs and alcohol? There are some covert narcissists that will run to drugs and alcohol so that they don't have to feel pain, okay? They're the kind, they'll put a Band-Aid on something because they don't want to face the problem. They run from problems. So some of them could be addicted to alcohol. They'll go out drinking. You have a fight with them. They'll run to the local bar. They'll go, you know, drink themselves to whatever because they don't want to have to deal with you and coming home and facing you. Or they could be somebody who takes painkillers to numb themselves out because they can't deal with it. So understand this. Covert narcissists are really very weak individuals, okay? Because they don't have the strength to face something head on. They can't deal with being wrong. Their ego is so low and so fragile that they can't handle when they're, you know, shown to be wrong or anything like that. So they play these mind games, these indirect mind games. And a covert narcissist will always try to portray that they have this huge image, all right? They're going to portray the exact opposite of what they are, you guys, all right? They're going to, you know, try to impress people by bragging about their promotion or bragging about their new car or bragging about their raise or bragging about their new hot tub in the back or something. They're going to be, they want to impress people, okay? Covert narcissists also, they'll try to impress people by wearing designer labels, okay? It's got to have a designer label. They're so worried about how people view them. They're so worried of, you know, their exterior image, what people think of them. And they're going to try to put you down and play mind games with you. And how do they do that? They may say something to you to the effect of, well, you have no friends, okay? Where are all your friends? So what does that tell you? That tells you that a covert narcissist judges people by how popular they are. The covert narcissist wants to be around the popular people, the people that get all the attention and admiration, or the good-looking people, or the successful people, or the money people. That's where you'll find the covert narcissist kissing ass, okay? And trying to be accepted as part of that group, okay? And they play these mind games, and what they're going to do to you is they're going to try to break down you and say something like, well, you have no friends, or nobody wants to be around you, or you have a problem with everybody, okay? Because they're validating who you are by how many friends you have, which is not how you validate somebody. The strongest people are sometimes the loneliest people because they don't want to be around toxic people, because they can stand alone. And the other thing you got to remember too, when you're dealing with a covert narcissist, is they can't be alone. Most of the time, they can't be alone. They've got to have somebody somewhere in the corner, okay? It could be a love interest. It could be a family member that's one of their flying monkeys. But they understand this. Covert narcissists always play games and have flying monkeys that are going to cheer them on. Oh, yeah, you're right. Oh, yeah, I feel sorry for you. And the covert narcissist, the mind game that they play is they play the victim. They want everybody to feel bad for them. Their game, okay, understand this. The game of the covert narcissist is to play the poor me, okay? And you're the bad guy. Say goodnight to the bad guy, you guys, like in Scarface. You're the bad guy, and they're the victim, okay? And they're going to go to these outside people, and they're going to manipulate them to play like, I did so much for them. I was always there for them. You know, I went out of my way for them and everything like that. Meanwhile, the covert narcissist was only there for you maybe one time. The other nine times they ghosted on you, okay? But they're going to play to everybody else that they've been there for you and that they are the victim and they're this sweet, empathetic person. And then these outsiders are going to hate you because that covert narcissist made you look so bad, made you into the monster that the covert narcissist is, okay? The covert narcissist, also another mind game I want to bring up, you guys. We all know that covert narcissists love to cause reactive abuse. That means that they love to torment you and, you know, they want to trigger you so that you react. You get angry, okay? And how do they do that? They gaslight you. They lie. They say things like, well, I don't remember, or that didn't happen like that, or honestly, I can't recall. Anytime somebody says honestly, most of the time you got a liar there. Liars use that word honestly, just so you know, all right? But this is what they're going to do. They're going to gaslight you till you get really pissed off and you explode, and the covert narcissist is going to sit there and they're going to say, why are you getting so angry? Or you have anger issues. The covert narcissist's goal is to make you look crazy, okay? Mind games. They made you look crazy because you reacted to their bullshit, okay? Period, dot, end of fucking story, all right? They're snakes in the grass. They're not transparent. And you've got to get away from these people because you will never get transparency from them. They can't be transparent and you will never connect with them. They are opportunists. They're out for themselves and they usually migrate to where the money is. Okay. So understand that when you're dealing with, you know, covert narcissists and mind games, it's all about being passive aggressive. And they feel that because they stay in control with their emotions, most of the time they stay in their control with the emotions, you, the one that's getting all emotional, is going to look like the nut. And that's exactly what they do to make, to win people over, to make it look like everybody else. There's the bad guy. There's the bad guy. You're the bad guy. And poor me. That's them. Poor me. You know, I just wanted to work it out with you and you get so hostile and everything like that. This is all manipulation, you guys. This is a snake, all right? And you've got to recognize it. The minute that you see toxicity, and I did a reel on this, you guys, the minute that you see anything shady, okay, anything that doesn't feel right, trust your gut. Stop with the second, third, fourth chances, all right? If you're feeling that coldness from that covert narcissist, there's a reason for it, because that person is secretly jealous and competitive with you. And it's up to you to recognize that nonverbal language of that covert narcissist. Remember this, covert narcissists operate in a nonverbal, silent, discreet type of way. Okay, how do I know this? Because I've dealt with so many of them. Okay, I've seen it time and time again. But at the time, for many years, I didn't recognize this. I just felt, oh, you know, I'm dealing with difficult people here. No. And when I educated myself, I said, I'm dealing with this covert narcissist. All right. This is the epitome of a covert narcissist. Passive aggressive, smirk, silent treatment. You know, say everything's right when it's not all right. Pay you back indirectly. You know, like, for instance, one time I said to my ex, you know, where's the hammer in the garage or something like that? And he got annoyed about that because I was bothering him because he wanted to relax on the couch. And guess what he did? He took everything out of the garage, threw it all over the den, and left it there all day long to pretend he was looking for that hammer or whatever I asked for, to make me feel bad for asking him, do you know where the hammer is? Okay? Passive aggressive covert narcissist. That's exactly what that is. And you've got to recognize it. Most of the time, you know, you start to feel bad about yourself and you say, was it something I said? You know, did I do something wrong? No, you didn't do nothing wrong. Okay? You're just dealing with an asshole, a covert narcissist. All right? So recognize it. And I'm trying to make people woke on this, so that they recognize it and know that, you know what, nobody deserves to be treated like that. Nobody deserves to be treated because they have a problem with communication. It shouldn't be, you know, abusive to you. You know, because they can't communicate and say what's on their mind because they're a fucking coward, it shouldn't, you know, make you feel like there's something wrong with you. And that's what I got to say about these covert narcissists. The minute you see any kind of like weird shit or cold and hot or slamming a doors or something like that to get their message across, or showing up late all the time when they say they're gonna be on time, or face at a family party to make everybody feel uncomfortable, guess what? You're dealing with a passive aggressive covert narcissist, and you need to get the fuck away from them. Okay, I hope that helps you guys. If it did, please hit the subscribe button and please share the podcast. Have a great day, you guys.